Christen, det er din far.
Goddag.
Velkommen, Maria.
Tak. Hvor er det dejligt at se dig.
I lige måde.
Sig goddag til din onkel Peter.
Goddag.
I må nok hellere se at komme afsted. Så I ikke mister jeres plads, men det er chancen.
Skal du ikke med os?
Nej.
Peter kan godt lide at ordne det ind i bilen i gang imellem.
Hello.
Ma'am.
Where are you going?
My wife doesn't speak the language. She will learn.
Du ligner dem ikke kun. Du lyder også som dem.
Det kommer jeg også til.
I'm sorry, there's been a mistake. You'll have to take the next coach.
But we'll pay for these seats.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
This is no way to treat newcomers. We have been traveling for weeks.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but you'll have to get out.
Vamos a hacer lo que el hombre dice. Forskellige dyr. Der er ræve, der er bjørne, der er hjorte.
Er der bjørne der, hvor vi bor?
Hvor vi bor? Nej. Der er ikke nogen. Men hvis der kommer en, så skyder vi den. Og så flår vi den og sender ned i byen.
Er der en by i nærheden?
Mm. Ikke så langt for os. Det vil være på en dag. Jeg begynder, ja. Et rigtig dejligt sted, hvor jeg har bygget til, så der er plads til os alle sammen.
Men hvornår er man egentlig stor nok til at tage med ud på jagt?
Det tror jeg faktisk, man er i morgen. Hvis du har lyst.
Had a drink for 3 years. Kind of forgot what this stuff will do to you.
Out here, bring your offer to drink, man. Your drink.
Wait, pretend to talk. Something like it.
You ain't got a hell of a lot to say, do you?
Ah, I like that.
My own princess, she don't talk at all. mute. The engine's cut her tongue out and she's a little girl. I suppose they got tired of hearing her scream after they killed her parents. Ah. What is your name?
My wife's name is Marie.
That's a beautiful name. You just come out here?
My wife and my son did, yes. I've been here for a while.
It's not so easy for anyone to be without a woman for such a long time. God damn, it's hot here. You're not used to this heat, are you, Marie?
No, I suppose not.
There is always a solution. This is what you got. Don't do that. Such a warm little flower. Don't do that. I'm telling you to get your hands off and behave.
Kind of sounds like he's threatening me. That's the impression I got. What do you say, Lester?
Yep. I'm not trying to threaten anyone. I'm just trying to...
Lower your gun. Do it!
Goddamn son of a bitch! I don't like you much, dude! You have 5 seconds to get out of here. You understand me? One.
Thank you.
be fine! Wait, wait, wait! Wait! She ain't dead! Wait, wait, wait! Wait! I didn't touch the boy!
Gjorde. Jeg har ikke set dem før. Fremme.
Sad day, Mr. Delarue. But we must bear in mind that no one in this peaceful town is involved in the gruesome killing of your men.
Where's my brother?
Your brother?
Mayor Keene.
Sir.
You make sure he doesn't stink of booze when the princess sees him.
Of course. You bring him to my house, I'll make sure he looks his best self.
Take him there. Did you catch the killer?
Mr. Delarue, I can assure you, it ain't nobody from around here.
I need to know who killed my brother.
There's no witnesses survived. Whip and the shotgun were shot dead also.
You lost two lives today. One my own blood. I will give you 2 hours to find the man that did this. And Sheriff, I want that man alive.
That's impossible.
You are a man of God, Sheriff Malik. I'm sure you've heard the words of our Lord. A tooth for a tooth.
Yeah.
Yeah. You have until noon to find the man that did this. Or you bring me two of your people.
Mr. Delarue.
You choose two, Mayor Keene. Or I will take four.
Of course.
I am ready, Father.
The whole town will always be grateful to you.
Take good care of my grandson, you hear me?
We'll try the best we can. I, for one, will help the boy run the store.
This isn't right. I'm not sure I can make it without you, Grandma.
Of course you can, my boy.
Please don't. Please, Father. Please help me, please, Father. My life's not that bad. I don't want to die. I've never been a burden. I'm innocent. I'm innocent. Please don't.
God have mercy on your evil soul.
Everybody, stay calm.
Well, Sheriff. A tired old woman, half a man. That didn't add up. That man's death. It's on YouTube. Tell me something, Mayor Keene. How much does Black Creek pay in protection?
$80 every month.
It seems to me you're gonna need more protection with the killer around. Now on, that fee is doubled.
Mr. Delarue, this is barren land. We can't generate those amounts.
$160 due at the end of the month, every month. Until you find the man that killed my brother. Are we in agreement?
Yes, yes. Yes, we are.
I thought we would be. Rest in peace, Princess. I will find the man that killed Ball. And I will personally make him pay the price. That's a promise. I will take care of you now. Together.
Ir a ver al sheriff.
Where's your grandmother?
She's dead. Delarue shot her.
I'm sorry to hear that.
What can I do for you?
I got some skins. We're going west.
Two men around here know how to shoot a leaving.
Guess so.
Aren't you two soldiers back where you came from? And we could use people like you if we're ever gonna face that murder.
Yeah, I was a soldier once, and it taught me a lesson. Don't get into a fight. You know you're gonna lose.
Cowards.
Who's that?
John. Well, it's good to see you in town for once.
You still buying up land?
I do occasionally, yeah.
How much will you give?
Well, I couldn't possibly give you more than 145.
That's half of what we paid for the land 6 years ago.
Like I say, times are hard. You know, since Delarue raised his fees, there's a lot of people want to sell. Still, you're a good man and I want to help. Let's make it 150. Or you can bide your time. Who knows, if they find the man who killed Delarue's brother, well, tempers may calm and prices may rise.
What man?
You don't know? Delarue's brother just got out of jail. Some lunatic killed him. Shot everyone on the stagecoach. Since then, it's...
I'll take the 150.
You won't regret it.
Oh. I'll need you to sign this. Here. Use that.
Where will you go?
We'll try and find a place further west.
I'd probably do the same if I was a young man. That's for you. And this is for me. You'll need to keep that money somewhere safe. In your boots, maybe? There's a lot of hungry people out there.
Collected sum of $3,148 and 12%. You're entitled to $3,524.76.
Let's make it a dollar.
Madeline takes pride in making sure those books add up.
Well, devil is in the detail. The company doesn't like the way things are going. Are you aware that the sheriff in Black Creek wired the federal government for help? I managed to block the communication for now, but you can't go on using the same methods you used in the army. These people are not Indians. Standard Atlantic is a modern company, Colonel Delarue, and we need our operations to look civilized. Am I making myself clear? Good. Now, how long before Black Creek is bought up?
I'd have the whole valley bought up in a week if you let me do things my way.
Just answer the question.
You keep the cavalry out of the equation, I reckon it'll take me 3 or 4 months.
That's all I needed to know. Good day to you.
Civilized, princess. Hell, I guess I can do that. As long as we keep piling up the money.
Take it from here.
Let Pete run. Malik. He wasn't on that stagecoach. He's not in Holderness.
He broke a deputy marshal's jaw. So he's going to have to take his legal punishment for that. But unfortunately, things are going to be a little bit different for you. I'll have to send word to Delarue that we got you in custody. I'm sure you're aware he's been making life hard for all of us. Don't know what happened to him. He used to be a good man. But I guess killing all those Indians for us must have unsettled his mind. Now I'm sorry for your loss, John. Yeah, I am. You seem to have followed him right down the same path. If you'd just shown a little compassion for Delarue's brother instead of killing him, then Mrs. Borowski and Mr. Whistler and Joan Olak, they'd still be here.
I won't be the last man Delarue's gonna kill around here.
Nope. Probably not. But your death's gonna buy us some time. I already wired for assistance. Try and restore some law and order. Sometimes you gotta sacrifice a single sheep to save the rest. I'm just a shepherd guarding his flock.
Say you were a soldier. Did you have a fight in the war?
I did.
Who was the enemy?
Germans.
Germans? Oh. You have my respect.
Son of a bitch that killed your beloved husband.
Your beloved husband killed my 10-year-old son. Then he raped my wife.
No one asked you to talk. Find out what you're made of, soldier.
You're late.
I'll be with you in a moment, Henry. Can I have his boots?
Go ahead.
Kid, you won't be needing these, my friend. Not where you're going. Christening this morning, so Sunday mass gonna take a little longer. You give him water if he asks for it, and don't get excited.
Grab some water.
Nope.
Thank you.
sorry to turn my back on you. But the view is better from here. Got you pretty good, didn't I? I mean, you were ugly before I knocked out your teeth. But now, hope you have a woman that loves you. Of course, you ain't gonna find one with that face. You probably never could get anything without paying for it. Not with that stupid voice of yours. But it's gonna cost you extra now, that's for sure.
Shut up!
I actually did you a favor. I mean, it's better now. Now you don't just sound like a sick mule, you look like one too.
I said shut up.
People won't be as surprised when you open your mouth.
God damn it, I'm gonna kill you.
It's probably a family thing. I'm sure your whore mother sounded like a mule when you were conceived.
Thank you. Get the horses.
They split up.
Corsican, big hat to men, follow this trail. The rest come with me.
Thank you.
your sister inside the house, Billy. And take Daddy's gun. We don't want you here! You shouldn't drink from the well. It's full of that sticky oil. I left you some bread and boiled water.
Thank you, Mrs. Whistler. Why are you leaving?
Delarue killed my husband. Sorry to leave you like this. You want to come with us?
I'll be fine.
He's gonna kill you.
Paul, he saved you from them Indians. But he never did straighten you out. God damn it. Now I gotta kill you.
That's a shame. There's nothing wrong with the body.
Once again, good fortune smiles down upon you, princess. Once you've all had your way with her, cut her throat. My boots back.
Your boots? Sure. Sure, I kept them here for you. I kept them nice and clean. Look. Here.
Did you buy Mrs. Whistler's farm?
Yeah, I believe I did, yeah.
Have you got her deed?
What? Look, this is all very confusing.
What about my deed?
You want your money? Huh? Sure. Sure, here. Here it is, John. Take it all.
What were you doing up at De La Rue's place?
Someone who died, you know. I mean, everyone deserves a coffin, even though they ain't gonna have one.
Henry.
What?
You called him Henry. Get the lid off that coffin.
Sure. I'm an undertaker. That's what I was doing. I mean, somebody's got to take care of these matters.
Get him.
Oh, look, I'm just trying to make a good living, you know? That's all. I'm a businessman.
You're not even a man.
Please don't.
Get him.
He won't get away with this.
Get him.
I'm the mayor of this town. I try to help people. Nobody wants the land. Please don't. No, please. No! No, please, John, no! John!
You're right, John. I don't keep the deeds. I give them to De La Rue.
I need a revolver, a holster, and some ammunition for my Winchester. Give me a knife as well. I'll pay for it. I also need 2 bottles of kerosene. I want you to go to Malik. Tell him that Keene has been making money on all of us. All that land and houses he bought wasn't for himself. He's been selling it on to De La Rue. It's that sticky oil. De La Rue believes it will soon be worth thousands.
Think you and your brother are gonna fight De La Rue on your own?
No. My brother's dead.
Let me come.
You're just a kid.
I'm not a kid. I turned 16 in May.
And I've been practicing my shooting. I'm not a bad shot. You don't stand a chance on your own.
His own coffin. Burn him.
I underestimated you, soldier. You may have killed all my men, but you sure as hell did.
Get him in. You know, all his men. You know, we've been hoping, praying for someone like you to come along, save us from our misery. And that's what you did. Only good souls left now. I thought you got them all.
She's coming with me.
Go down that path, John.
I want you to leave this place.
May the Lord have mercy on both your souls.
Thank you.